Hello my dear friends, welcome to our channel Aspire 32, and this is your friend Dr. Suresh Shenvi. Today I am going to discuss with you a simple material, that is Resin Modified Glass Ionomer Cement. This video is important mainly because I feel the students are sometimes confused with so many types of modification. Before going ahead with Resin Modified Glass Ionomer Cement, let us first understand how the glass ionomer cement came into the market. The first aesthetic cement, also the first fluoride releasing cement, is actually silicate cement. The life of silicate cement was not good. So they came with lot of modification. They came with silicophosphate, then they came with copper cement, they came with zinc phosphate, they came with zinc polycarboxylate. Now zinc polycarboxylate was very good because it was the first cement to chemically bond to the tooth, and it also had fluoride release. So if somebody asks you which is the first cement to release fluoride, it is the silicate, but silicate never had a chemical bond. The first chemically bonded cement is zinc polycarboxylate, which also has fluoride releasing property. The zinc polycarboxylate cement was not very good in aesthetics. So the researchers took the powder of silicate cement, took the liquid of zinc polycarboxylate cement, and came with glass ionomer cement, which was very popular and even today used very routinely in day-to-day practice. Now this material, which has the original composition, is called as conventional glass ionomer cement. Now if you read the Phillips or the dental materials book, basically the glass ionomer cement is classified as type 1, which is luting, type 2, which is used for restoration, and type 3 for bases. So we basically use type 1 and type 2 very routinely in our clinical practice, and students sometimes have to give the exam by showing the mix of glass ionomer cement. So questions on glass ionomer cements are very common. The advantages were really good for glass ionomer cement, that is the conventional glass ionomer cement. It was more aesthetic than any other old cement. It had high fluoride release than any other cement which was introduced before. It was stronger than any other cement when it comes to compressive strength, and of course it was more aesthetic. Many people started using this conventional glass ionomer cement, that is type 2 glass ionomer cement, to do routine restorations, although it is not considered to be a permanent restoration in permanent tooth now, but during those days type 2 conventional glass ionomer cement was used for restorative purpose. Now you may have heard a very common advice that if you have done restoration with a glass ionomer cement, they will ask you to coat it with a varnish or Vaseline. Now why is that needed? It is important to note this point before going ahead with resin modified glass ionomer cement. Now a conventional GIC has a free water and bound water in its matrix. The basic matrix is formed because of a reaction called as acid-base reaction, where the polyacrylic acid from the liquid will attack the powder particles and form a matrix, and this water is very important for this matrix formation, and over a period of time the matrix will get mature, and this free water will get lost and the bound water will be absorbed by the reaction. Now suppose you have done this restoration and now you took the aerator and with that coolant you started finishing. What will happen is this basic water content will get increased, which will affect the final strength of the conventional glass ionomer cement. In other case, you took the air syringe and before application of these protective agents you dried the cement. What will happen is the water will get lost. This also affects the final strength of GIC. The main disadvantage of conventional GIC is moisture sensitivity. That's why we really avoid finishing of GIC immediately. Now rather than asking the patient to come back after, you know, the next day to finish it, researchers wanted to improve the moisture sensitivity, and that is where the resin modified GIC came into the picture. Now if you remember, if you want to make any product water resistant, we generally coat it with a plastic. A plastic is actually made up of monomer, which will cure and form a polymer. Now in dentistry, we have this monomer as a resin in composite. So what researchers did is they took this monomer and put it in the powder particle, and they took a polymerization activator initiator in the other component of GIC. And when you start this polymerization, the original acid base reaction will continue, but the cement will set because of this initial resin polymerization. Now if you want to do a polymerization, we require a source of energy, and we have light as a source for initiating the polymerization. So that's why this resin modified glass ionomer cement is also called as a light cure GIC. So what the initial reaction will do is it will basically form a resin matrix into the original matrix, and it will block the water, and the initial set will happen. So you are allowed to do initial finishing of GIC without affecting its water content. So over a period of time, this conventional GIC reaction, that is acid base reaction in this original composition, will continue. So we have initial light cure resin reaction, and in the next 24 hours the original acid base reaction will continue. Now one thing this will lead to is it will also trap the fluoride ions into the GIC. So the fluoride release is considered to be less with resin modified GIC, as mentioned in many books. At the end, I would like to tell you few important points again so that you remember it. The light cure GIC is actually a modification of type 2 conventional GIC. So it is a restorative GIC. It is also called as resin modified GIC. So resin modified GIC and light cure GIC both are similar. The main advantage of light cure GIC is less moisture sensitivity. The other disadvantage of light cure GIC is the fluoride release may be less. So my dear friends, I hope this solves the confusion of resin modified GIC. If you are confused about dentin bonding agents, pulp capping, do check our other videos. If you like this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the bell icon so that you don't lose any other videos when it is uploaded. If you have any questions, feel free to mention it into the comment section. I will see you again. Have a good day.